first place, but it's not even 800. Oh, what? Oh, man, why did it have to be that run? You know, I say that, but I'm not good at the song at all, so I've never completed a run with without doing the double squeeze on Act 2, so I have no, like, frame of reference for how to get good ticks. I'm actually really surprised that my third act got the back end in general, because I realized with my ticks that bad that even against the first place, I was going to need something. I was going to need some decent amount of ticks on that blue sustain on the third act activation. That's not, like, to throw any shade at... I think his name is Billa on Score Hero. His YouTube page is, like, Fijole Moy Mol something, I'm guessing Eastern European. I have no idea, but it's not like he himself was proud of his, you know, ticks on this, so it's kind of whatever. I hope so. If I offended you, I'm sorry. That's not my intention. It's just to say that I had no frame of reference for this. I really at least wanted 222.8. I might just go back and try to do that, because I'm not happy with this either. It's just to say that, yeah, as far as ticks are concerned, I just didn't know what I was doing on this, but I was very disappointed to have dropped the yellow sustain before the strumming in the middle of the first act. That was something that I pretty much just now started to realize was an issue, where I was dropping ticks. I don't know how. I don't feel like I'm letting that note off early, but whatever. It's the same thing as Soy Bomb on that first act. This is just really surprising that I managed to get this, I guess. I can see why this, why Billa was the only one to have this double squeeze for as long as he has, because it's rough, man. I had to really grind this out in practice mode to get down just a somewhat consistent method for that front end. It's definitely a tough squeeze, and it's for multiple reasons, like, made A, much more difficult, and B, much more awkward because of the game engine. The first problem is that the note before the front end is a strum that follows a hammer-on, and so, like, you know, for most people, including, whatever, for myself, when I have an activation coming up, especially one that I'm trying to use extended hit window on, I try to hit the previous note early, right? You want to give yourself as much time to prep and whatever, but because that note before is where it is, it's really shitty to do that, because a lot of the time it'll just eat your strum input as the hammer-on read beforehand. So I just miss all the time because of that. And the other problem with the activation is that it precedes fast strumming. So yeah, there are multiple ways that you can get screwed over by the engine here. The method that I settled on after some practice with it was just empty strum, you know, activate, fret, traditional extended hit window, and then do the triplet all in, like, one motion, which is, I'm pretty sure, what most people would do for this without extended hit window, but with the quote-unquote extra frames that you're trying to push out of extended hit window, it's even more important to do that. And then I actually just strum the note after the triplet in that same motion, so it's essentially a quintuple strum, but the first one is a little bit segregated from the others, and then the last strum in the quintuple is a little segregated as well. So really I'm just describing what the fucking note pattern is, which is really stupid and embarrassing, but the point is that it's pretty much all in one motion, and that makes it a lot more doable Because it, yeah, it's really awkward and whatnot. Aside from that, I, like I was saying at the beginning, I really don't know pretty much anything about the rest of the song. I know there's not a lot to get, but just for example, I don't know if you even get, if your star power for the third act is, like, overflow. That was something I was worried about. Like, do you have to early whammy those notes? You know, obviously you just don't want to drop ticks, but at the same time, you need star power to get whatever ticks on the blue and hit the back end. And I just didn't know that. The final act, I honestly feel like you might be able to get another note on with, at least with extended hit window on that green. Obviously, that would be much harder to utilize there because of the fact that it's a sustain that leads into a fret of the same note. So you have to get all the ticks from the note, or, you know, try to get all the ticks from the green and then let go and then refret. So that's always really annoying. But yeah, it seems pretty lenient with the squeeze the way it is now, but you know, I always think that kind of stuff and then it turns out to not be true. So yeah, that's about all I have to say about this one. This is the first time that I've ever had to use, or that I've, you know, been able to use glitch ticks. I didn't realize why I was losing so many ticks compared to the first place video for a while, and then that finally sprung into my head that maybe it was something to do with that. It was, so it's pretty cool. Yeah, I just don't have that much to say because I just don't have that much experience with this. This is a bad score. I'm sorry for that. I might go back and do this for 229.8, or I might, who knows, man, I might task this to see if that final act is possible and push for 230. That would be pretty crazy. But as it stands now, this is somehow first place, and I'm going to take it, I guess, for now.